Mr. Lewandowski, I'm going to put a slide up, and it's the words that President Trump dictated to you on July 19. Can you read what you wrote down?
I'm happy to have you read it, Congressman.
Well, why don't you want to read it, Mr. Lewandowski?
I think you should afford me the same privilege you afforded Director Mueller.
Would you like to read it?
No, you're welcome to read it.
Are you ashamed of the words that you wrote down?
President Swalwell, I'm very happy of what I've written, but you're welcome to read it if you'd like.
Are you ashamed to read it out loud?
I'm not ashamed of anything in my life, Congressman, are you?
Then why don't you read the words?
Congressman, I've asked and answered your question.
Mr. Lewandowski, why won't you read the words aloud?
I've asked and answered your question, Congressman. If you'd like to read the words, you're welcome to.
Well, you were ashamed to read them out loud, and you didn't deliver those words to the person the president asked you to. Did you have a consciousness of guilt?
I have nothing to be guilty of, Congressman. Thank you.
You still feel guilty today, and that's why you can't read it out loud?
Congressman, you're welcome to read the words if you'd like.
Well, I just wonder why you can't.
I have the capacity to, Congressman. I'll give you the privilege.
You said the president did nothing wrong. Why can't you read those words right now? Why can't you read them aloud?
Congressman, tell me why you hold me to a different standard than previous witnesses who sat here.
I want to give you one more opportunity to clear up something you said earlier. You've said a number of times if it was in the Mueller report, it was accurate, except as it relates to you stating that this was the only time the president ever asked you to write something down. Are you saying that that part's not accurate? And I'd ask you to stop the clock while he confers with his lawyer.
Clock will be stopped for 5 seconds.
Could I see the page and reference number on that, Congressman?
Sure. It's page 91, lines 7 and 8. I will read it to you. This was the first time the president had asked Lewandowski to take dictation. Are you saying that that is not accurate?
I'm saying those aren't my words, Congressman.
I'm asking you, was that the first time the president asked you to take dictation?
And I've testified it's not the first time.
So this part would be inaccurate.
I'm saying I've taken dictation by the candidate and the president in the past.
Have you ever put any words that the president asked you to write down before in a safe? Or was this the first time you'd done that?
I believe it's my standard operating procedure when taking notes, Congressman.
So every note that you take of the president, you put in a safe? How big is that safe?
It's a big safe, Congressman. There's a lot of guns in there.
Is this the first time you've ever put a secret message from the president that he wanted you to deliver to someone else in the safe?
I don't believe there's anything secret about the message. I was never told to keep the message secret.
Is this the first time you ever put a message that the president asked you to deliver to someone else in the safe?
Not to the best of my recollection.
I want to go back to that day. Later, after the president asked you to deliver this message, he was interviewed by the New York Times. And the next slide shows that he said, Sessions should have never recused himself. And if he was going to recuse himself, he should have told me before he took the job. I would have picked someone else. That's not what the president said to you during that meeting one-on-one in the Oval Office, is that right?
The White House has directed that I not disclose the substance of any discussions with the president or his advisors
Mr.
to protect
Chairman,
executive branch
Mr.
confidentiality.
Chairman, I'd like to stop the clock for a parliamentary inquiry. The
gentleman will state his parliamentary inquiry.
I would like to
Mr.
Chairman, I'd like to request a ruling on the witness's refusal to answer.
Mr. Lewandowski. When you refuse to answer these questions, you are obstructing the work of our committee, but you are also proving our point for the American people to see. The president is intent on obstructing our legitimate oversight. You are aiding him in that obstruction, and I will remind you that Article 3 of the impeachment against President Nixon was based on obstruction of Congress. You are instructed to answer the question. The clock will start again.
Mr. Chairman, parliamentary inquiry.
Gentlemen. The gentleman will state his parliamentary inquiry.
Is it correct, and I can repeat, or you could let me see your little sheet there, that reference you made to Nixon was after a formal inquiry was put to the House and then brought back to the Judiciary Committee. Your statement's a little bit different than this. Just wanted to point out truth for the record. I yield back.
I have a parliamentary inquiry, Mr. Chairman.
First of all, that was not a parliamentary inquiry. He didn't even ask anything. But who seeks? The gentleman will state his parliamentary inquiry.
Mr. Chairman, did you just threaten to impeach Mr. Lewandowski, a private citizen?
No. And the plain import of what I said was that he is violating the law by refusing to answer these questions. The president is violating the law by instructing him and others not to answer these questions. And Article 3 of the Nixon impeachment was based on this kind of obstruction of Congress by President Nixon.
One further inquiry, Mr. Chairman.
Gentleman will state his parliamentary inquiry.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. So does that mean then, pursuant to your statement, that this is an official impeachment that we're in?
I have stated repeatedly that this committee is, and we amended our rules to empower the chairman to designate specific hearings, which I did for this hearing, is pursuant to finding out, to determining whether we should vote articles of impeachment against the president. That's exactly what this is.
Thank you.
The gentleman from California will continue.
Mr. Lewandowski, I'll ask you again. This, what's displayed on the slide, is not what the president told you in that one-on-one meeting. Is that correct? Are you refusing to answer, Mr. Lewandowski?
No, Congressman. As I've explained in a letter from the White House dated September 16, 2019, to my attorney,
Mr. Lewandowski's
conversation with the president and with senior advisors to the president protected from disclosure.
We stop the clock again for this obstructive behavior.
Mr. Chairman, point of order, and I'd ask the clock be stopped.
The clock will be stopped, and
the gentleman
will state his point of order.
My point of order is, Mr. Chairman, this witness continues to obstruct the work of this committee by refusing to answer questions. He's been ordered to do so by you. I ask that you adjudge him in contempt in these proceedings.
Point of order, that's not a proper parliamentary inquiry.
It was a point of order. It wasn't a parliamentary inquiry.
Excuse me. I will take that under advisement.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Gentlemen will continue.
Are you refusing to answer, yes or no?
Congressman, I'm happy to answer your question, so let me have the privilege to do so. As explained below, Mr. Lewandowski's conversations with the president and with senior advisors to the president are protected from disclosure by long set of principles protecting executive branch confidentiality.
As a result, the White House
is directing Mr. Lewandowski not to provide information about such communications beyond the information provided in the portions of the report that have already been disclosed to the committee.
The gentleman has the time, not the witness.
And Mr. Lewandowski, I'm just asking, if you're not going to answer, just say it's a refusal to answer. We don't need to be read the instructions from the White House. So I'm going to move on. In that New York Times interview, hours after the president spoke to you, he never said, in fact, I just enlisted Mr. Lewandowski to deliver a secret message to the Attorney General for him to direct the special counsel to limit the investigation. He said to you something that he did not say just hours publicly. Is that right?
I have no idea what he said to the New York Times.
Mr. Lewandowski, would you agree that delivering a secret message in the way that this president did as a former law enforcement officer who's probably investigated gangs and mob-like behavior, that this is consistent with that?
I take exception to your premise of the question that it was a secret message.
Mr. Chairman, I yield back.